They say that a friend in need is a friend indeed. President Trump had endless friends before he ran for president, but when he needed the support of his so-called friends, they were over on Hillary's side claiming to have no association with him. Despite the fact that Trump won the presidency and has already accomplished an astonishing amount, these overly jealous liberal businessmen and former friends are now harassing Trump on every move he makes. One such businessman is Walmart CEO Doug McMillon. Freedom Daily reported just days ago about McMillon's brand of biting the hand that feeds him by stabbing President Trump in the back. Trump has been encouraging manufacturing in the United States as a way of boosting the economy and creating jobs, clearly something that Walmart isn't interested when it comes to cheap products. Perhaps this is why the CEO came out in condemnation of Trump's response to Charlottesville, making the false accusations that he's racist. According to the Washington Examiner, Walmart CEO Doug McMillon criticized President Trump's response to the violence in Charlottesville, Virginia, over the weekend, but said he planned to remain engaged with the White House in a statement posted on the retail giant's website. McMillon wrote that Trump missed a critical opportunity to help bring our country together by unequivocally rejecting the appalling actions of white supremacists. Trump did not specifically call out white supremacy and racism in his first comments on the violence in Charlottesville on Saturday, although he did in a public appearance Monday. McMillon said Monday's comments were a step in the right direction and we need that clarity and consistency in the future. So apparently, Walmart and McMillon are perfectly willing to criticize the president and try to turn the nation against him, despite all the work he has done to support business in America. And the position is really just fine if that's the route they want to take. They're completely within their rights to disagree with the president on something. What seems a little bit shady and two-faced is that now, they're trying to rip him off, following the support he garnered for his hurricane relief trip. President Trump wore one of his iconic trucker hats when he was visiting Texas after Hurricane Harvey ripped it to shreds. The hat got a lot of attention, partly because you can have one of your very own, from the Trump and Pence website. But that's not all. For the low, low price of one quarter of what the Trump supporters pay, you can go to your neighborhood mega retailer and trade in your loyalty for a hat that looks almost as good. Via Daily Mail, Walmart has cornered the market on cheap knockoff baseball hats that look like the caps President Donald Trump sports, and now they're doing it with a hat he wore during his assessment of the damage in Texas from Hurricane Harvey. It started when Walmart copied Trump's famous red Make America Great Again headgear. But as the president's style evolves and grows, so does his patriotic campaign hat collection. The big box store just released a line of USA hats with 45 on the sides indicating the 45th president of the United States. They look almost identical to the ones Trump wore in Texas, 45 and all, only they're offered for $9.99. Trump's official campaign hat, left, and the Walmart knockoff, right, sold for a quarter of the price but look almost identical. Trump's campaign sells the official USA caps on their site for $40. The president was also called out for hawking campaign gear during his visit to the Lone Star State by the watchdog group Citizens for Responsibility and Ethics in Washington, or CRU. Jordan Leibowitz of CRU pointed out to CNN that wearing the hat even removed from the hurricane is pretty inappropriate. Leibowitz argues Trump is using his various appearances as free advertising for his campaign swag. Walmart still sells the Make America Great Again headgear, and again at a discount.